Welcome back. So in this video, I'm going to be covering the quick search portlet. Now, if you want more information on searches in general, and especially global searches, we have a global search module. But right now, I'm just going to be talking about the quick search portlet, which is a bit of an alternative to doing global searches. So let's take a look at this. All right, here we are in our home dashboard. Now, down here on the left, I have the quick search portlet. You may have that in a different place, or you may not have it at all, in which case you can always add it to your home dashboard. But right now, I'm just going to pull this up so we can have easy access to it. Now, as you can see, the quick search is pretty straightforward. You basically just put in what you're searching for. And how it differs from the global search is that you're also clarifying, you're kind of narrowing it down in terms of the category of thing you're searching for. So you have this whole list of things, everything from events, tasks, sales orders, transaction numbers, customers. So let's take a look at a customer, and let's just put in Atlas, and let's do a search on that, just to give you a concept of kind of how that works. So here we have three customers that have the word Atlas somewhere in their name. That comes up. So we can go back to our home dashboard and see, and notice, by the way, that this went back to name slash ID. So it's currently set as a default to search for name and ID. And that's going to be important in a second. But that's basically how you do a general search. And just so you know, what we're looking at right now, even though it says quick search, we are looking for a general search, which means we have the ability to choose a kind of narrowing down, and then we're searching for that. There's a second way, if we go over here to setup, we can actually make this portlet not just a general, we can kind of narrow it down even more specifically to a transactional search. So if we select that and hit save, we notice our portlet will change. It now says transaction search, and it gives us a few more options to put in here. Now, keep in mind, you still have a category listing here that you can get more into the kind of specific type of transaction than you could in the general search. So let's take a look at, let's say, sales order. So if I put in sales order and I do, let's say, Atlas again, I can put in other parameters. And if I do, keep in mind, these are and searches. So the name, and if I put a date, it's going to have to, whatever comes up has to match the name, the date, the number, the PO check number. If you fill all of those in, it's going to look for something that fits all of those requirements, not just one of them. So you do need to keep that in mind. If you just know what the customer name is, don't necessarily try to narrow it down by date if you feel like you're not 100% sure on that. It's better to get a little bit of a larger list and just make sure you select exactly what you're looking for. In this case, let's take a look at sales orders for Atlas. And we get this whole list of any kind of sales order that relates to any customer that has the name Atlas in it. So if we go back, that's basically how that transaction search goes. Now notice it's not giving any kind of preset type here. So let's change that. Let's make it default. So right now we have it search type set up as transaction. And if you come down here, default transaction search type, it's currently selected as nothing. We can change that. So let's say, good, we always want it to be a sales order. So we can set that. And we can also set, if we have it, the portlet set up as a general search, we can set what that is as well. So let's say we want it to be customer. So we're going to save that. And now we have the sales order automatically coming up no matter what. So even if we change it and then we refresh this page, we go back to home, it will bounce back to sales order. So that's just how you kind of set it. So whatever you're most commonly using it for, maybe you're a sales rep that's always pulling up customer information, you probably want it set to general search and then having it listed default as customer. So depending on how you're using it, you can set that up. And again, you can always use the global search above to do searches, but this quick search is just a really fast way to, if there's certain things you're just always looking for and you want to be able to kind of cut out just a few extra steps, this is a great way to be able to accomplish that. All right, that's it for the quick search portlet. I'll see you in the next video.